Hello everybody, Destiny 2 is launched on the PC, and I'm already max level, which is level 20, which is, it's like the morning of day 2, I'm already level 20. It's not that hard to get to max level, but I figured I would give you guys my thoughts on the game thus far before I jump into most of the end game stuff. That way I can kind of have a, you know, initial thoughts video, which is this one, and then a end game thoughts video when I finally get around to doing all of that, and when the raid launches next week. Don't worry about any spoilers in the background. All of this footage is just kind of like public event stuff and just me wandering around. So I'm avoiding the main story on purpose, just in case you don't want to be spoiled on it. But how is the game thus far? Is it any good? I would say it's actually extremely good, and this is boiled down to a couple things. The first is that the core gameplay loop is really fun. The shooting is really, really good. And playing with other people is very satisfying. And in fact, a lot of the things you're doing in the game, like getting headshots, or I think they count them as like critical hits or whatever you want to call it, because it's not always a head that you have to shoot in order to get the bonus damage. That is very satisfying. They make really good sounds, and the like explosion death is really nice. So essentially, the game is really, really fun to play, which means that it carries it quite a bit through the process of leveling. The gameplay can be repetitive. I mean, it's a shooter. What do you expect? If you've played things like Borderlands, you know what I'm talking about. It's a lot of shooting things and collecting loot and putting that loot on. If you like Diablo-style games, this is probably a game for you, mostly because that's exactly what it is. You're running around and you're doing pretty repetitive tasks, but you're getting a lot of rewards for doing so, and it's not very stingy about it, which is always really satisfying because, you know, you do, say, a mission. You go through a process, you get to the end of that process, you get some really nice loot out of it, you put that loot on, and you go, all right, where's the next place I'm going to find loot? And it's this kind of nice reward loop that you get yourself into just by going and playing the game. However, things can be a little repetitive, and I think that the repetitive nature of the game is something that you can't necessarily avoid. There are very different things that you do in some of the main missions and some of the strikes, and you know, as you get to max level and you get a vehicle that you can drive around in, like your own vehicle, things are a little different. But for the most part, the game is you're running around shooting enemies that are spawning, and some of the enemies are, you know, very difficult to fight, and you have to use different types of weapons to kill them. So there is kind of like a rock, paper, scissors system in the background that you're having to keep an eye on. So while it's repetitive, there is other things going on to keep your attention outside of the shooting just being super freaking good. And I've seen the game, the first game that is, played on console, never really had any desire to play it. I wanted to, but it wasn't on PC, and I'm not a console shooter. I don't like using controller to shoot. Someone who grew up playing a lot of Quake and Unreal Tournament, I need my mouse and keyboard, and this game fulfills that for me. It takes what I thought was going to be really cool with the first game, which is the RPG aspects, the running around, looting, and shooting, that Borderlands-style stuff, and it puts that on PC in Destiny 2, and I'm just really happy with the games thus far. But like I said, if you're playing with other people, that makes that enjoyment go up quite a bit, as it usually does with multiplayer games, as you might expect. But in this case, it's way better because you and your friends can kind of make fun of the game when it's being a little maybe too repetitive or a little cliche in the story. The storytelling isn't the storytelling is fine. The story itself is pretty meh, you know. We were joking around, and this is, you know, part of the reason why playing with other people is really fun, because you could do this thing. We were joking around that the stakes in the game were set way too high, way too early. Very early on in the game, you learn that the big bad guy's trying to essentially destroy the sun, and we're joking around, like, how could the stakes ever be any higher? It's like they could say this planet that you're on is about to blow up, and it still pales in comparison to, I don't know, the sun exploding, because it'll destroy the entire solar system. So they put the stakes way too high, way too early, and from then on it just feels like everything you're doing is fairly mediocre in comparison to having to stop the sun from blowing up. So you know, the story is okay. It's not the best. It's a space opera kind of thing, but it's no Star Wars. You know what I mean? It's not super good. The storytelling itself, as in the way the story is told to you, is done in a pretty enjoyable way. The voice acting is very good. You know, you have people like Nathan Fillion doing Cade, which he is just phenomenal in almost everything that he does. As a fan of a lot of his stuff, seeing him in this game with his sense of humor that he has and the way he delivers his lines, it carries a lot of the dialogue once you get Cade kind of in the main missions and having him have his dialogue back and forth, because you're essentially, you know, you're stuck with one person to begin with, and then as you go, you get the rest of them in there, as you might expect with any game that is introducing characters along the way. And they do a pretty good job of explaining the story to you if you've never played another Destiny game. Like, if you never played Destiny or any of the expansions, then jumping into Destiny 2 is fine, and you don't need to know anything, because they do a good job of delivering that story to you in a way that makes a lot of sense. Relatively, yes, as you could probably imagine, you know, you're going to miss out on some things. You're like, what the heck is the Traveler? What did it do? It does a pretty good job of giving you some context, but it leaves enough to the imagination, which is a really hard thing to do in storytelling. You don't want to explain everything to the player, that you make yourself feel intelligent when you figure things out just by the context that they're giving you when they say certain things. So yeah, the storytelling itself is great, but the story in itself is pretty mediocre. And that's fine, because the reward loop that you're putting yourself into of getting loot and running around shooting things, the story is all just secondarily a thing of the game. It's not something that you're actually having to really focus too much on. You can enjoy the story, sure, but you know, it's pretty obvious it's only there to serve the needs of you running around and shooting things. And that is totally okay. There is nothing wrong with that. I'm just glad that they didn't put too much emphasis on the story to the point where it ruined the gameplay loop as it is. Very few times in the game does it actually keep you from playing. There is one spot right at the beginning after the little intro thing where you're having to... It's one of my biggest pet peeves in games when they do this, where you're having to move really slow for a very long amount of time, for a way unnecessarily long amount of time at the beginning of the game, because you're having to get from point A to point B, but it's trying to tell you a story, so it's like, hey, take things slow, so it forces you to move slow, and you're just like, ugh, just let me move fast and let me move on with this, because this is unbearably slow, and it's just not fun. There's a one or two other times where it will put you into a scene where you're waiting for dialogue before a door opens. That's usually fine, because the dialogue, again, is so well delivered that you're pretty okay with that to begin with. But it is annoying that you have to wait for the dialogue to finish before the door opens. It's like, just open the door so I can get back to shooting things. This is one thing that Doom did really, really well with the 2016 game, was that you would just kind of go in and punch a lot of stuff in the face, and it knew that the story was ridiculous and secondary to the actual gameplay, so it served the gameplay in a way where it made the gameplay better, because it made you realize that it wasn't taking itself seriously, the story, and or rather it was taking itself so, like, there was one or two directions you can interpret it. It was either taking itself so seriously that it was B-movie-ish, which is kind of what it was doing, or it wasn't taking itself seriously at all, which makes it more of a B-movie to begin with. So you kind of get where I'm going out there. The story in Doom didn't matter at all. The developers realized that, so they just let you run around and shoot things. And in Destiny, I kind of wish that they did more of that, where they wouldn't just put me behind a door and everything. Because slowing me down, even if it's only for like 10, 15 seconds, doesn't feel fun. Keep the gameplay going, allow me to keep shooting things, because that is the fun part of the game. But now let's talk about the classes. So you have three classes in the game. You have the Titan, the Hunter, and the Warlock. And then they each have their own subclasses. So there's three subclasses in each class, which is fine. That's pretty normal for RPGs. So for example, I'm playing the Hunter. So there's like the, there's an Archer one. I don't remember the name of it. There is the Arcstrider, I think it is. And then the Gunslinger. I've been playing the Gunslinger. I like the Gunslinger. It's what I played the Hunter for. It's because it's more focused on the shooting aspect of it and precision, which I enjoy a lot because it rewards good gameplay when you're doing well. Although when you're not doing well, it feels pretty bad, man. But the other two subclasses are also really fun. The problem is you don't have access to them at the beginning. You don't get to choose your subclass. It gives you one right off the start, and that's the one you're stuck with until level 7 to 8 when you collect an item that comes out of chests randomly. So you're going to have to be opening chests around those levels. You get that item, and then you have to empower that item, which is really annoying. So you go and you have to go do public events, or you have to just go kill things, and it'll slowly fill the percentile up to the point where it's done, and then you can go and get your first subclass. So for the Hunter, the first subclass, I believe, is the Gunslinger, unless it randomizes. Pretty sure it's always the Gunslinger. You start with the Arcstrider, and then you get to the Hunter, the Night Stalker, or whatever it's called, for the third one. But that comes at like level 14 to 15. So at level 7, you know, you're going to get your first item. So that means around level 8 or 9, you'll be able to go get your first subclass. And then again, level 14 comes around. You'll probably get your item around then. And then around 15 or 16, you'll be able to go get your second subclass. I don't like that at all, because it forces you into playing a subclass that you may not necessarily want to play to begin with. And this is an issue that popped up when I'm sitting here playing with my friends, because my first subclass that I get, the Arcstrider, is really fun to play, and I had no problem playing it. I got to run around and melee stuff as a hunter, and it was really fun. It was very satisfying. And I'm going, I want to play the Gunslinger, but I'm okay with what I have right now. And then, of course, my first subclass I get is the Gunslinger. So I get that really early on, and now I'm playing the subclass I want, and everything is just peachy. Unfortunately, the two other people I was playing with leveling up, they both wanted their third subclass that they get at level 14, 15, 16-ish. And them just sitting there being like, why can't I just have my subclass now? It made me feel bad that I already had mine. And that's no fun. That is bad design. I understand slowly feeding it in, but why not let you choose at level 7 which one you get? Why not let you just choose from the beginning? Hey, which of these three do you want to play? You know, it just tells you, like, Arcstrider does a lot of melee, the Gunslinger is a lot of shooting, and the Night Stalker, or whatever it's called, I literally have no idea. I just picked it up, and I don't ever plan on playing it. That one is, you know, it's got some more control things, some more support. Which of these three do you want to play? And then you would choose one. I don't understand the desire for them to treat the player as if the player isn't going to have any idea of what they want, and then just giving you one at 7 and then one at 14. The good thing is you level up so fast that you'll get them very early in comparison to the amount of time that you'll put into the game. So there's that. And the other thing is, it is a little nice if you have a brand new player who's never played these kind of games before, comes in and just kind of lets it go from the beginning. You know, you get your first one, they have no idea what a subclass is until they get, you know, their second subclass unlocked, and they go and do that, and they go, ooh, I have all these other skills that I can potentially use. Like, that's cool, but it feels like it's too restrictive. It's too much holding the hand of the player when it doesn't need to. You need to treat the player as if the player is an intelligent being and can figure this stuff out on their own, because when they do figure it out, it will feel really, really satisfying to them. But that is one of my main gripes, is that whole system, the whole subclass system. It's nice that once you have all your subclasses, you could just switch between them. It's all peachy. It's really nice. It's also nice that, you know, I've played the game as my hunter, and now I'm going, the game is so much fun, should I level a Titan or should I level a Warlock next? Like, I'm already considering leveling the other two characters up and getting them done, because it's just a fun game. And you know, if I'm going to be playing group stuff with strikes or with raids when the raid unlocks next week, you know, if I have to choose a very specific class because maybe we need that for something to make it that whatever we're doing easier, then I would have no problem going and switching to another one of my classes. That's just something that I enjoy doing, you know, in, say, other MMOs that I play. So it would be something I enjoy doing now. And the fact that the gameplay is so much fun, I wouldn't mind redoing the main story or even some of the little bits in the world, that, you know, like the public events, because it's just fun. It's fun to play, and it makes me want to play it more. And so far, my early impressions are that the strongest part of the game is that it is just fun to play. And because it is fun to play, you're going to really enjoy just doing the basic gameplay loop, going over and over, doing your typical grinding stuff. So if you're into these kind of games, it's absolutely worth it to pick it up if you haven't picked it up yet. I still probably would wait till next week to kind of see how things shake down. I was expecting the launch of the game to be a little more rough than it was. However, it seems like launching at 1 o'clock p.m. Eastern time was a really good idea, because that means that the server load wasn't going to be super high. I only ever disconnected once, and I think that's because I disconnected from Battle.net, but not the game. The server stability for the game has been just spot on the entire time. So good work on Blizzard for setting up that infrastructure for them and setting up the server and everything, and the social aspect through Battle.net. And good work on Bungie for making sure that it was going to be a smooth launch, because that was kind of my big sticking point, is I wasn't sure whether or not it was going to launch smoothly or not, and that was going to be probably one of the worst parts of it, is if it didn't launch smoothly and we all had to wait in queues or anything like that. None of that happened, so it launched smooth. It's all good. And outside of that, the game runs great on PC. I'm oftentimes with all of my settings maxed out and at 110% render resolution, which just kind of makes the game a little sharper. I'm often running above 70 frames per second in big open areas with a lot of people, and that is perfect. That's perfect for me. I have a 60 hertz monitor. I don't need to run the game at 120 hertz, or rather 120 frames per second for a 120 hertz monitor. Otherwise, I would be doing that. So keeping it just from 70 to 90 frames per second is kind of my ideal go-to for my rig. If I was running a high frame rate monitor, which I do have one, it just happens to be my second monitor because it's a little smaller and a little older of a monitor. I use that one, you know, just for editing purposes and other things like that. So I don't need the game to run at 120 frames per second. But if I turned down the shadows a little bit from the highest all the way to high or even down to medium, I can easily get to 130 frames per second. That was based on my experience of messing around with the settings. So it runs really good on PC. It plays really well. There have been no server issues and the game has launched well. So far, the game is a success and I would suggest it. Again, I'll make another video next week on what I think of the end game after doing all of the strikes and kind of going through the loot grind and seeing how that all goes. Obviously trying out the raid and doing that and probably playing the other classes. But thus far, I feel like I haven't even scratched the surface on a lot of the content, because you look at these big open maps and there's a lot of like little things that you can go do, which is awesome. And I like that. I like that I haven't quite gotten there yet, but I feel like when I do, I will have no problem being like, okay, that was fun. That was worth my time. That was worth the money that I put into this game. Awesome. Cool. Bye. You know, and just taking a break until the content drops happen, because there's going to be like big patches that essentially DLC is what they're going to be later on outside of just normal stuff. So, you know, we'll see how that goes, and I'll probably revisit the game's end too and see how that's all doing. But thus far, they're starting off strong and they've kept my attention, and I'm liking it a lot more than I thought I would. And everybody I was playing with and everybody in our clan is like, this game is really, really good. And that's like the best compliment you can give this game, because we were all kind of a little hesitant. Like, is this going to be very good, or is it just going to be like, eh, it's okay, and then we move on with our lives? Either way, though, I think I've already gotten my money's worth out of it. And I, again, probably haven't even scratched the surface. Probably going to play the game for at least another 20 to 30 hours based on the end game stuff, and we'll see how that goes. It's a lot of fun. Yeah, totally worth it to pick up if you haven't yet. But those are just my thoughts. I would definitely, if I were you, not necessarily only look at one person's thoughts of this game. Definitely check others out, because they, you know, my thoughts may align differently with yours, because right now this is falling in a really good time for me. I have a break of content that I'm, you know, working on, or rather working through, you know, in WoW, which is the kind of the MMO I'm playing at the moment. We're waiting for the next raid to come out, which is going to be after BlizzCon, and I'm kind of waiting for Star Wars Battlefront 2 to come out. So this has come out at the perfect time for me, which is why I'm able to devote a lot of time to it and enjoy it. But you may be, you might have a Nintendo Switch, for example, and are going to go play Super Mario Odyssey all weekend. Then maybe this isn't a game to keep your attention for the time being. But again, check out what other people think on it. And then if you haven't picked it up yet, make your decision, because I think it's really good. I don't think you're going to necessarily get left behind, because it's really easy to level up and get to max level and get all the gear that you want. But yeah, we're enjoying it, and I think that's the best praise that I can give the game as of right now. But let me know what you think of it if you have picked it up, because I'm curious to kind of get a read on what the community is thinking about the game in its stages at the moment, and where you think the game will go. Are the content packs that are going to be coming out going to be worth it based on what we saw from the first Destiny? You know, The Taken King was apparently really, really good, so I'm kind of expecting that level of quality for, you know, all of the content drops that we're going to get for this game. And maybe Destiny 2 will have a longer content tail than the first game, because they kind of switched to Destiny 2 production fairly early on after Destiny came out. So we'll see what their plans are for this. But so far, yeah, really good. Let me know what you think, and we shall see you guys next time.